Hello, I'm Mats Olsson, and this is the third and last video in the series of doing the right thing, even when no one is looking. In the previous presentation, I had touched on ethics and compliance matters. Now it's time to round it off with integrity. Integrity is doing the right thing even when no one is watching. British author C.S. Lewis wrote this, and he really hit the nail on the head. Integrity is moral soundness. It's showing your built-in compass with all the right values. I mean, our image is what people think we are, but our integrity is what we really are. And today, with a more and more transparent, fast-moving and technological business society, I'd say that in the light of many scandals, those of us in the industry showing integrity has very much to gain. One very good initiative in this area is the Power of One idea from the Scottish Institute of Chartered Accountants. They talk about moral courage as the sixth and standalone pillar next to the five fundamental ethical principles IASPA has put out. In my mind, I would say that the moral courage is an important part of the integrity. To start with, we auditors and accountants, I mean, we are supposed to be honest and trustworthy. We are in many situations supposed to be independent. We are supposed not to show only competence, but integrity and also moral courage. Anthony Colella and his institute from Scotland expresses this very clear in a recent article on the Global Knowledge Gateway, in which they stress the importance of seeing to the public interest and not to your own private benefit. I would like to take this a bit further. Showing real integrity will probably, at the end of the day, bring you private benefits, one way or the other. Not showing integrity isn't sustainable these days. Just look at many of the financial scandals the last few years and think about what would have happened if we in the business had stood up instead of bent over. As I see it, it probably is easier for an SMP, a small and medium-sized practitioner, to demonstrate skills like integrity than for someone at a large firm. Why, you might ask? Well, if a colleague of mine at a large firm has to oppose the management or a big owner of a public interest company, it might end up in the both local and national news. And regardless of what's going on in the background, the auditor will almost always lose in the eyes of the public. And perhaps also lose other engagement. When I tell my clients that it's either my way or the highway, we might lose the engagement, but it never ever ends up in the media, and we can continue doing the work we should do in the right way it should be done. Apart from showing integrity and doing the right thing, another important benefit of showing integrity, I think, is the way the millennials look at us. The evidence, as you can find in the Edelman Trust Barometer for 2016, it tells us that they want to work at places and have roles in which they feel they can do important things and can make a difference and also benefit society. Bending over backwards just to keep the client and their money runs directly counter to that. In the end, you lose that kind of client anyway, and before that you will probably lose a good employee. Presently, the IAASB are working on a project on professional skepticism. I have no doubts that importance of that project and the importance of skepticism, absolutely not. Skepticism is and must be part of our DNA. But in my mind, integrity is all the more important. I mean, no matter how skeptical we are, how technically skilled we are, and how independent we are, if we don't show integrity, it all means nothing. I've heard integrity mentioned as one of the ingredients of independence along with objectivity and skepticism. Well, no matter how you define it, it is a soft skill. It's hard to label. When you meet someone with real integrity, well, you just know it. What can we in our business do in order to show more integrity? Well, I think we have to start with the tone at the top. Sweep the stairs from the top and all the way down. We have to walk the talk, we have to be real. But walking the talk is probably easier running an SMP than the more politically charged environment that goes with a larger firm. I mean, there are few people who go into the doctor just wanting to hear that all is well until suddenly it's too late to do something. And I would say the same applies to our clients. If something isn't right, in most cases, they want to know about it, and moreover, what can be done about it. For some clients, the medicine can be too hard to swallow. And if that client doesn't want to do the right thing, it's vital that you part ways. But whatever you do, don't concede and hope it will resolve itself next year, because it rarely ever does. It's important to remember, if you lose integrity, in the final reckoning, you will also lose trust. And trust, that is the bedrock of our business. I mean, we are in the business of forging trust, so it's essential we keep doing the right thing and we can show our clients, our staff, our partners and stakeholders at large what we stand for and believe in. What if IFAC does what the Scottish Institute has done? Remind all member bodies and its members that it's our professional duty to take a personal responsibility to do the right thing. Thank you for listening in.